Hi, and welcome to our second part of our five-part anti-burglary tips. Anti-burglary tip number two, make it difficult to break in. The second thing burglars look for is easy access. The tougher it is for a burglar to get inside, the less likely you are to come back to a burgled home. Never leave doors or windows open. Never hide a key to your house outside where it can be found. Use solid core or metal doors that are secured with high-quality deadbolt locks. Try to find or ask the locksmith for door locks with an ANSI Grade 1 rating. Deadbolt locks should have a horizontal bolt at least 1 inch long. With shorter bolts, a burglar can more conveniently use tools to expand the doorframe and open the door. Consider using locks that have an internal anti-saw pin that makes it difficult for a thief to saw through the bolt with a hacksaw. Likewise, some locks include an anti-drill feature, using hardened steel chips inside the lock that will destroy a drill bit should a burglar try to drill through the lock. The casing, which is the outside housing of the lock, should be made out of hardened steel and be beveled. A hardened steel casing makes the lock more resistant to force, and the beveling helps to prevent a burglar from using a pipe wrench to twist the lock free. A metal strike plate is attached to the jaw jamb to hold the bolt or latch in place. The most well-known way for a thief to force a door open is to kick it open or by kicking at the plate. You can make this harder by using a heavy 4-screw high-security strike plate. The wood screws used to attach it should be 3 inch long. That way they will go through the jamb and be tied up in the doorframe stud. Using at least one long screw in securing each door hinge will additionally secure the door against forced entry. Treat a door between an attached garage and the house as an outside door and use the same type of locks that you use on the front and back door. Any window or glass panel in the door that is closer than 42 inches to the lock should be reinforced with an unnoticeable security film so a burglar can't break the glass or reach through to unlock the door. Windows should be connected to a home security alarm and have locks that operate from the inside so they can be used for escape. Windows can also be made stronger and safer by coating them with an impact-resistant film. Another home security measure for windows is to attach stops that prevent them from being opened more than 6 inches. If you do, though, everyone in the home needs to know how to remove the stops to make an emergency exit. Use a metal or wooden rod in the track on sliding glass patio doors to prevent them from sliding open. Do not leave behind a ladder that could be used to access the roof or a second-story window outside in an unlocked shed. Cut down tree limbs that hang over the roof and remove any lower branches from trees next to the home. That's it for part 2, and stay tuned and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more great home security tips. Also feel free to contact us on 0860 100 202 or visit our website at citiprotection.co.za for all your home security needs.